it's your girl Jackie, just doing a really quick little tutorial for you guys right now. I am having trouble adjusting the volume of my voice because I'm sick. I feel like I'm talking really loud. I'm having trouble controlling the volume of my voice. You know when you're sick and your ears are all plugged up and you can't hear anything? That's how I feel right now. I've been basically in bed all day, you know, watching the Whitney funeral and crying and whatever. And then I was just like, you know what? I have to get out of bed at least to do a tutorial. I decided to do my current everyday sparkly look that I pretty much wear. And I'm not even kidding. I wear this look every single day. I don't know if you guys do this too, but I'll just kind of come up with a look and I'll like it so much that I'll make that my go-to look for every day, just because it's very easy to do in the morning. And when you have a look that you do every single day, you can get the look down really quickly, and so it's really easy to put it on and just be on your way. Every time I do a talking kind of video lately, I'm wearing this look, and I get a lot of comments of people asking me what it is. Can I do a tutorial on it? So I just figured, you know, since I get so many comments on it, I may as well do a quick tutorial. What else did I want to talk to you guys about real quick? Oh, okay, so my nails, I got my nails done. I generally get a lot of questions from you guys every time I do something new to my nails. So let me show them to you first real quick so you can see. They're gel nails. I've got black polish with glitter on top, and then I did hot pink polish on my ring fingers, and I actually love these nails a lot, and I'm sure you guys are gonna have questions. So what I did, because I wasn't doing anything else earlier, is I went ahead and I did a blog post on my nails. In that blog post, I've detailed everything. I've got the color polishes, what number, what brand they are, what salon I went to get this all done at, and everything. So all the details are in there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to put a link down below in the information box, and I'm just going to link to that blog post so you guys can go see everything I did to my nails. My neighbors are so annoying right now. Oh my God. So it's Saturday night, so the kids across the way are throwing a huge party, and it's very annoying because y'all know me, I like to party and I can't because I'm sick and it's driving me crazy. But that's okay because Madea's family reunion is on and I love me some Madea. So I'm going to get back in bed, watch some Madea. Oh my God, I sound like a man. My voice is really deep right now. It's kind of scary. Okay, so first I'm gonna start out by putting a base on the eye because this is an everyday look. This is something that I apply very early in the morning and I wear until late at night. So I'm going to use NYX eyeshadow base, and the color that I'm going to use is the white shadow base with pearl. The reason why I'm going to go with the white one is since I'm laying down a white eyeshadow, I want it to really pop, and so it kind of helps, especially since the eyeshadow itself is kind of shimmery. This white will help fill up any gaps between the shimmeriness. Whatever. Anyways, I'm just gonna use a regular old, oh, isn't that pretty? I got that from e.l.f. A regular eyeshadow brush. And you can use your fingers for this. What I usually do is I just pick up some of the product and then I just put it on my hand just to kind of warm it up a little bit. But I apply it with the brush because I feel like I get a more even application with that. So I kind of start just underneath the brow line. And it kind of helps to find the brows too a little bit. And then I go all the way to the lid. And you're gonna want a really light application because this stuff does crease a little bit if you put on too much. So you're just gonna wanna go light like this. I'm not gonna apply any more product. I'm just going to blend out what I have and leave it there. So I'm just going to lightly define my contour, not very heavily. I want this to be a very light look. So this is just for a little bit of shadow. I'm going to take a brown color. The one that I'm using is by Too Faced, and the color is called Cocoa Puff. Let's see if we can focus there. It's this brown one right here. It's got a little bit of shimmer in it. It's actually not as shimmery in real life. I think it's because the light is hitting it directly. But you can use any brown you want. You can use a matte brown, whatever you want. This isn't even gonna show up that much. It's just gonna look really subtle because we're not using that much of it. So I'm gonna go ahead and taking a crease brush, I'm just going to, what I like to do is I start along the lower lash line and bring it up. And then I just bring it into the crease like that. And I don't go down here at all because I want this area to be completely white. And this looks kind of sloppy, but I'm basically just placing it. I'm gonna blend it out after I place the color. Okay, so now that I've placed everything, I'm just gonna take this same brush and I'm not putting any more product on it. I'm just going to blend it upward and outward. And again, you don't want anything on the lid. I actually messed up and got a little bit there, but I can clean that up. But just keep blending it out until it looks like that. You don't want it to be too dark. I may have picked up a little too much product. That's okay. You can work your way through anything, girl. I don't even know what the hell accent that was. Okay. So I'm just going to blend, blend, blend. So now I'm going to go in with the highlight color, and I'm using Sin by Urban Decay just because it's a really nice go-to color. It's really easy to use. It's a little bit shimmery, but it's really close to my natural eyelid color, which is why I like it. Because you don't want anything that's going to stand out too much. You just want a little bit of highlight. So I'm just using another regular eyeshadow brush. I'm just going to pat it on underneath the brow. And then I put some here in the inner corner as well. And underneath the lower lash line. So now, taking my white color and the same eyeshadow brush I used to place my NYX base, I'm going to put this white color all over the lid. The one that I'm using is by Stila, and it's their jewel eyeshadow, and the color is called Opal, and I love this so much because it's just the right amount of shimmer if you wanted to do a daytime shimmery look without going overboard, because it doesn't have really huge glitter pieces. Now, the only thing about this eyeshadow is it's really expensive. It's $20 a pop, so there is a more budget-friendly option. So let me show it to you guys. This one is by Revlon, and it's their Diamond Lust shadow, and this color is called Celestial Silver. Let's see if I can focus there. There we go. So it looks really silver right here, but it actually is a lot lighter in person, and it looks pretty close to this one. It's just a little bit more shimmery, and there's some more glitter flecks in here than in this one, but the difference is this one's $20, this one's $4.99, so that's a really huge difference in price. So if you're worried about that, go with the Revlon one. But if you have the means, I highly suggest picking up this one because I love it. So I'm gonna pick up some of this, and very carefully I'm gonna pat this on because you don't want any fallout, because you don't wanna have sparkles underneath here, especially not if this is a daytime look. And the good thing about the base that we just applied is that it's very sticky. So there's gonna be something for this eyeshadow to stick to. So I'm just going to pat this carefully on the lid. I'm not going beyond it whatsoever. I really want to concentrate this only on the lid. And then bring it upwards just a little bit to blend it out. Now, taking the crease brush I used to apply the brown color, and I'm not putting any more product in here because there's usually enough in the bristles to just to do a little bit of blending. And if you put on more product, it's going to mess up the whole thing. So I'm just going to touch this along the top of the white just to further blend it a little bit, and see how it just creates a little bit more definition just along the outer edges, being very careful. So now I'm taking a makeup wipe and just kind of cleaning this up right here, and now that looks a whole lot neater, doesn't it? I'm gonna put on some eyeliner. This one is by Maybelline. It's their Master Precise Eye Studio Ink Eyeliner. This is what it looks like. It's just like a liquid ink pen. There we go. See if we can focus there a little bit so you guys can see what that looks like. It's just got like a really fine point. This camera does not want to focus right now. Come on. There we go. So it's got like a really fine point, which is why I really, really like it. So I am going to, as you can see, I'm not really winging it out too much, again, because it's an everyday look, is I'm just going to draw a thin line across the top of my upper lash line. So now that I've applied that, I'm just going to touch this along the lower lash line as well. And if this gets a little sloppy, that's fine, because I'm going to clean that up with a Q-tip anyways. I just like to use the liquid liner along the lower lash line too, because it's easier to make a fine point in the inner corner. Just like that. And now I'm going to bring it out here so I can do, I guess it's a little bit of a wing, not too much. So I'll just bring this up a little bit and then connect it to the top. So I guess we'll just call this a baby wing, a wingette, if you will. So taking a gel liner, I'm now just going to do a little bit of tight lining here. So I'm just going to apply this gel liner to the lower waterline and the upper waterline as well. You can skip this if you want. I just really like black eyeliner. You guys know I'm obsessed. So it doesn't really matter where I'm going. I always want black eyeliner. So it's probably why I have to take it easy on the eyeshadows, because I really like to amp up the eyeliner no matter what I'm doing. It's just a personal preference. You don't have to if you don't want to, but I personally love it. So now for the rest of the look on my cheeks, I don't really use blush just because I feel like it's a little too strong for every day. So I just go with a bronzer on my cheeks instead. So the one that I use, you guys have seen me use this like a billion times before. It's by Lorac. It's called the Tantalize Me Baked Bronzer. And I basically just pick this up with a kabuki brush and kind of run it along my cheeks. And that's the end of the story. I don't even really bring this with me for touch-ups. I'll usually just bring the kabuki brush with me because there's enough product left over in there that I can kind of touch up if I need to, you know, if I'm going to go out later or whatever. And for the lips, I keep it pretty simple as well. Again, you know, I don't want anything sparkly on the lips because I have sparkly on the eyes and I don't want to overdo it. So I just line with Prestige Lip Liner, and the color I use is called Cameo. It's just a really nice neutral, it's like a nude shade with a little bit of brown and a little bit of pink in it. It's really nice and it's very close to the natural color of my lips, which I love. And then on top of that, I go over it with the Revlon Lip Butter in Creme Brulee. And this, I got too much stuff in my hands, girl. Okay, so this is what this shade looks like, and it's just a really nice nude color. And what I really love about the lip butter is that it's so moisturizing. So can I just say, for the sake of full disclosure, that I am completely obsessed with the Revlon lip butter, so much so that I've actually had to pick up a container. Those of you guys who have seen my makeup stash, actually, I'm gonna just show it to you guys right now. So as you can see, I have a bunch of these little thingies, and I have one for like my lipsticks and my lip liners and my eyeliners. I'm so obsessed with lip butter that I had to get one just for lip butter. It's really sad. I just, you know, I find something I like and I just want like every single color of it. So yeah, I'm a little bit addicted, but that's okay because it's a good product. And that does it for my everyday sparkly look. I am surprised, honestly, that I made it through this video because I kept having to like pause the camera so that I could cough because I didn't want to keep coughing on camera. This cold sucks, okay? But such is my dedication to you guys that I was like, I'm not leaving them without another video. I just can't do that. I don't have that in my heart, you know? And plus, I'm just sitting at home anyway, so whatever. So anyways, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Hopefully next time you see me, I will be in good health. Health and not on my deathbed. But you know, the good thing about makeup is even if you're really sick and on your deathbed, you won't look like you're on your deathbed, because I think I look pretty okay. I think I look pretty normal considering how I'm feeling. So God bless whoever invented makeup. So anyways, I love you guys. Thank you so much for stopping by to hang out with me in a germ-free environment, because you're not up here collecting my germs. But anyways, I love you guys and I'll see you next time. Bye.